We'll have him speak his latest poem at end of the session. Thank you, Mr. Yadav, you're here. And again, thank you, Mr. Zuchi. I would like with that, I'll probably like to bring Mr. Shahzad. He's from right in Srinagar, Ground Zero, which we're talking about. I'm myself in US and Jeevan Saab is in US. We have a few people right from Ground Zero, Shahzad and Dr. Ghazala, Professor Muju. And I think we might have a few more folks from Kashmir, actually Dr. Sadiq Wahid Saab. So with that, Mr. Shah Saab, you know, you heard Mr. Zuchi, you heard Kaju Saab, you're on a mute. Please remove yourself, unmute yourself. Mr. Shah Saab.
Am I audible, Tasawur?
Yes, now you are.
I would request you before I speak, because I'm going to speak from Kashmir. Professor Muju is there, who is from Jammu. And he would definitely speak because he's from the Kashmiri Pandit community. That will be very nice to hear him, and then I would speak from Kashmir.
Okay, that sounds good.
If it is okay with you.
Yes, of course. Muju Saab,
because please. Professor Zuchi has just now, that the earlier speaker was Mr. Zuchi, correct?
Yes.
Yes. So that will be very nice to hear the Kashmiri Pandit view, actually. And then I will speak from Kashmir, if it is okay with you. Otherwise,
yes,
I am ready to speak.
No, please, Mr. Muju.
Because that will give it a continuity.
Yes, sure. So, Muju Saab, you are muted. Can you please unmute and maybe you speak?
Hello, do you hear me? Am I audible?
Yes, we can hear you now.
See, I think Mr. Zuchi has already given a good background about the suffering of the community. I am myself a victim of militancy. My father, who was just a very honorable educationist and teacher, he was assassinated on 7th of July 1990. Then we had to leave Kashmir. Then our entire property, literally A to Z was looted, house vandalized, and then we could not go back till date. Though I requested government to help me return, but they have done nothing about it. Since Zushab has already given the full picture about the suffering of Kashmiri Pandits, I don't want to repeat and take more time about that. We have suffered, we are suffering, and government has taken initiatives and steps for our rehabilitation so that we can go back to our homeland, our home state, and live there peacefully. So that is so far as the Kashmiri Pandits are concerned. Now, regarding the political issues of the Kashmir, about following 370 and so on, you see, basic issue is, you know, everybody knows of the history of Kashmir, how it acceded to India in 1947, what were the conditions prevailing that moment, how Pakistan invaded Kashmir, and how the case went to UN Security Council, and all those things. And then Kashmir to India was 4 months after the normal other states accede, because other states acceded 15th of August. JNK acceded on 26th of October. So there's the gap of four. And within this time, and it's acceded under certain conditions, were constitutional conditions, which are governed by Article 370. And we were enjoying the benefits of those articles for the benefit of state. Those special conditions were there for our, this accession to India. And no doubt, after 1953, when government India arrested Sheikh Kutla and things developed, it has was developed nicely with Kashmir situation. There have been mishandlings. Maybe local government has also mishandled situations and then misused some powers and misused it also. You cannot deny that fact. People are not happy there also. But on the whole, it was doing well. Then the way it was abrogated, though it was actually optional, I don't think it's abrogated. It has been only inoperative. It has not been very healthy because a sort of fierce psychosis was created before it was abrogated. Locals, non-locals were asked to go out. Paramilitary forces were sent there. A sort of panic and hysteria was created. So that way the means were not right. Though there's a need to remove it, that's correct. For the complete integration, 370 should have gone, and most of it are already gone. Because you know how the Supreme Court came, how election commission came, of the Auditor General came, or other laws were implemented in JNK. No commotion was created at that moment. And there's no need for sending force or other things. So the ways it was done has not been to the tune was expected from Kashmiris. And that's why it has created, I think, more of alienation in Kashmir and added to it. Now, the question of that, it will end militancy. I don't think 370 had to do anything with militancy. Because I feel from 1947 to 1987, there was no militancy. When Article 370 was there, you could have been there usually. In fact, the Kashmiris helped that in India in 1965. They didn't join the Pakistan that movement or other ways. So there was something internal was happening which probably created. And then 1987 was the climax of it all. So to say that this thing, and then if you say that abrogation will stop militancy, I doubt, because it is still going on. We find still militants working in this way or that way. Daily, a couple of militants are getting killed. Daily, a couple of soldiers are getting killed. And then Pakistan is not silent, is firing at the LOC and all those things. So this thing is going on. So this abrogation has not helped in curbing militancy completely. Then the question of development. Naturally, when militancy is there, you cannot put out all the development issues there and get provided all the economy has developed. And unfortunately, along with this, the COVID-19 has added to our misfortune. In fact, J&K has been under lockdown almost from 5th August 2019. Though, because of COVID, it was from March, but it was there because of this thing. So it has already added to the economic downfall of the state. Then it's unfortunate that the full state has been reducing union territory, which is very painful. And naturally, the articles should have been abrogated in concert with the local government, which have been, as have been with other articles and of the state. And the laws were implemented there with the concurrence of the local administration, with the local government. And unfortunately, such steps are not taken. Yes, in fact, I have put in my paper several times, the Article 35A needed some amendments. Because those soldiers, Gurkhas, Valmikis, though refused from Pakistan, the OKJ, they had no voting rights, they had no rights. So they should have been given legal rights by amending Article 35A, which was already in the Supreme Court. And their marrying of the girls, nonsense subjects, was again very important issue, which deprived them of the property rights. These could have been brought simple by amending Article 35A. And in fact, if you go to historical figure 35A, it was right from 1927. When Maharaja Harir Singh had given consent to state subject laws, then only locals could purchase, state subjects of J&K state could purchase land and get government jobs. So it's the only extension of that in 35 years there. And it definitely needs some amendments to address the grievances of this, sections which are affected by this implication. And that way 370 had nothing to do with that. 370 was basically purely a political agreement which could have, and then in fact 370 was almost it was left a shell only. Most of the articles were already there. It's a different thing altogether than 35A. So in short, I feel that it has not been handled properly, though there was no need to have as such 370 had things been normally been there. But when it has been done has been felt very badly by the people of J&K state. And they feel humiliated and then insulted by having the union territory. So government has to think of sometimes a restriction or something, whatever they can do about it. And then hope that what they promised, the economic development and all those things can be restored back. And at least immediately, you see, state has to be restored, Presently we are suffering because there is no 4G and the communication channels are there, freedom of expression is not there. And you see, everything is not going on healthy lines there. Therefore, government has to take cause of these feelings of people. And then the question is, the basic issue has to be resolved. The basic issue of J&K is resolved, and you cannot resolve it unless you take Pakistan on board. You have to take Pakistan or discuss it. You have to take a dialogue with Pakistan, talk to Pakistan. And there are two dimensions. One is the external with Pakistan, other is the internal. External peace with talks to Pakistan, discuss Pakistan, and because de facto Pakistan has a portion of India with it. So if you want to cut it back, it should be got back, and we had to discuss on that issue with Pakistan. You can't say either, no, we won't do it. You had to talk one day. Then the end for the local population, the civil society has to be taken into context. There's been dialogue with the civil society, and then with Pakistan and India, the cultural exchanges and all those things had to take place. So that the sort of, I must say, understanding is created between the two countries. You cannot just be remain isolated. Similarly, with regard to the problems, right, as you say, inside the J&K state, you have to take the local public council, cultural delegations, sports, and all those things can work. And that Kashmir has to be taken into confidence and integrated with the rest of the India, because he is already integrated. He is a part of India, so no doubt about it. But certain things happen, which is just added some alienation in the mind, which is to be removed by scientific means and by healthy promotion. Basically, because in Kashmir, it has become firstly sore in the subcontinent for this peace. Therefore, some measures ought to be taken so that there is issue resolved. And the solution to the problem basically lies in the problem itself. And the problem is Kashmir. Other things are the offshoots, which we add to the, to the problems of both countries, India and Pakistan, even the subcontinent. So if we resolve the Kashmir issue peacefully with Pakistan, with other internal problems, other things can also be resolved very quickly. So India-Pakistan dialogue is very essential for resolution of Kashmir problem, and other things automatically go away with that. Thank you very much.
Thank you, Mujib Sahab. Great. We see two diverse views. We see Mr. Zuchi is a Kashmiri Pandit representing Kashmiri diaspora in United States and different parts of the world. He has a view that Article 370 is good. The removal of Article 370 was good. And Mr. Muju, he is right in Jammu Kashmir. He's an editor, he's a Kashmiri Pandit. He opposes that view. So we're already very interesting. Debate going on. Thank you, Mujib Sahab. Could you please tell us the name of the newspaper you are the editor-in-chief of?
Yes.
What is the newspaper you run? Aren't you like running...
Voice of Silence. Voice of Silence.
Voice of Silence. Thank you, sir.
It's available on web also.
Okay.
It's on web also. www.voiceofsilence.co.in.
All right. Thank you, sir. Thank you.
Thank you, sir.
And with that, I would like to make a couple of comments before I hand it out to Shah Sahab. I just wanted to correct my earlier statement about Nagma ji. She is All India General Secretary of Mahila Congress and in charge of Jammu and Kashmir and also Puducherry. Also contested Madhya Pradesh elections from MP election, sorry, from Meerut, UP. And I've worked at... 9 different she has acted in 9 different languages. She's really multilingual. So maybe we'll have her present tonight in a different language other than English. Thanks for correcting, Nagma ji. I also have Mr. Satish Maldar. He is a Kashmiri, he's a coordinator of JK Minority Community, JK Minority Alliance Forum. He would like to speak on the plights of OBC, Minister of J&K, and I did definitely, we'll give an opportunity to everyone to speak. Since we're limited in time, I would really appreciate if you can be a little patient before I bring you on. I'd like to, with that, before I hand it over to Mr. Tanka, because he's the one who has to leave, I'd like to bring Mr. Shah to bring his view, because he also is right in Srinagar right now. Mr. Shah, please, you have the stage.
Yes, I would. Before Mr. Shah speaks, let me tell you, I'm having a babbu gosha, which a friend of mine from Kashmir has brought to me. It's one of the sweetest fruits I have tasted, babbu gosha.
You need to share with us.
Very true.
Okay, thank you. Shah Sahab, you are muted. You heard the view of Mr. Zuchi and Mr. Muju, and you're right. Please express your view.